First time I came to here, Honolulu, 1973. Then, when I came to Honolulu with Mike McCoy, Easter Peace Corps in my island, Sarawan, and when he come back to Honolulu for vacation, and he wanted to take me to Hawaii. And that time, they make meeting about ukulele. They want to build a kakano in Hawaii for sailing from Hawaii to Tahiti. That's the time I was there because I come with Mike McCoy. That's why he take me to the meeting in, I think it was Senator. Then, that's why they found me, because they talking about the navigator on the trip to Tahiti. Then, one guy from New Zealand, the name is David Lewis. They asked him, you know which one, the navigator? Then he said, you know one person from Pulwot? Yeah, the name is Sipo. Okay. The name is Sipo. And then Mike said, No, Sibor is the Eastern Affairer, but he don't know how to speak English. That's why they asked Mike, which one is you know? Then the guy stay with us tonight for him. Then they say, the guy can come with me this time. That's why they found me. And then they told me, okay, maybe later on you go back home, you wanna rest. You know why? Then we pay you again, come back to Hawaii. Then I go back home, I wanna stay, I forget how many months. Next year, 1975, then I come back to Hawaii. Then I come help them for Piritakanu Okule.
So did you teach them over there? Or?
No, the time we start Piritakanu, I never go teach them. I start teach them 1976. Sorry, Perm. He's the first. He's the first my student. And
on your island, did they approve of your sharing the information?
Well, yeah.
Did you ever imagine that it would go this far?
Met.
Did you think that the voyaging would go this far with Hawaii and the canoes going Makali'i and Hokulea? Did you ever think it would go this far?
Yeah. Because after 1976, and I was thinking maybe later on, no more nothing. That's why I teach the story permit first, Then after Nanua. Nanua is he started learn from me 1980.
Hey Mau, this voyage, when you actually landed on, when you actually went to Satawa, can you tell me what your feelings were like?
I don't know what I'm saying. Maybe, but I know that people, everybody is happy. But I think better Craig say something for about the trip.
Question?
Well, I asked him what his feelings were when you all arrived in Satawa.
The whole build up behind doing this trip was to, first of all, as we know, to honor him. But what happened during this whole trip, well, prior to Satawa, was a reawakening of navigation. Within Micronesia and the island groups that we touched. Yeah. Also, I'd like to mention that Mau was elevated through a ceremony, and the people in Micronesia honored him as by giving him the title of as Grandmaster. So, and this is prior to going to Sarawak. Yeah. The whole build up, every island, the first island we touched, the Mau. In the Marshall Island, there's a build-up there. Kusarai, and then Ponope, where he was honored extensively. And then Chuk, where his sons met him and sailed with their traditional canoe along with Makamakali. building this feeling, and this big, this strong feeling. So finally, getting into Sarawa was the epitome of not for Mau, but also for those that have been dreaming of this for a long time. So, as far as how his people felt, only their hearts could tell us because of their response to us when we got back there, you know. It was such an awesome feeling for us to be sitting in a canoe house on an island that is still intact, culture still intact, and to be sitting amongst people that the culture goes back, the intact culture goes back thousands of years, on this little island a mile and a half long and a half mile wide.
Other navigators on your island. I read something about it was the first time that you. There was one photograph. It was the first photograph
ever
taken.
Make me shake my camera.
All the navigators.
Right?
It's Sarawa.
It's Sarawa.
Yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah. Urupa, everybody remember?
Sarawa. Yes.
In
Sarawa,
so am I.
In Puluwatu.
Celestial navigation, what do you think? Where will it go from now, do you think?
The future.
Are there new challenges? Of course, right? Are there new?
Yeah, what's yeah. Happening with Papa now, and I shouldn't be answering this, but I'll just let me be prompted.
Because of his reawakening in Micronesia, he's been offered, and because of his status now in Micronesia, he's been offered opportunity to teach.
Oh.
That's why I'm worried about the people in Micronesia, not like before. Before, like every day, every night, they ask about the culture and life care, everything. But now, that's why now is they want to start learning from me about the life care, everything, because everything they lost.
So you will be teaching when you go back.
Uh-huh. Yeah, now it's when they take me to my island. And then if every island like Warape, Chuk, Yap, they think about me, about Lefkir, or everything, because everything they lost. That's what they, now is they give me the job in Yap. Yeah, now I make the canoe in here, and the canoe is finished. Then I go to Bonape, they make one big ceremony for me. And I go back to Yap, I'm gonna teach them in Yap. In this month.
Are you building a canoe here?
So no, the canoe from my Micronesia. But give to him and give to them. Then
we, this is we the come, one they
brought. Yeah, we come and fix the canoe.
Oh, I see.
This is a total learning process. Yeah. To build Polynesian canoes, we can do that. Yeah. Club of grass core, whatever. But when it came to we doing this canoe, what better than would it then to have the master himself come and teach us how they build their canoes, and so we can continue the tradition. The thing is, these two canoes are Micronesian canoes that was donated to us. But once they're completed and we sail, when these canoes become part of our education program, there'll always be a link between Hawaii and Micronesia, or between Papa and us. Yeah, even if after he passes and I pass, whoever, yeah, the canoes will still be sailing. There'll always be that link between his island and Hawaii.
I have a question about this. When you're on the ocean and you hear waves lapping against the hull, or tell something by that?
That's it. When I take it, sorry, Berman. Then everything I give him, because the culture is before, you know, before no more compass, no more everything. We use when we were sailing. We use the wave, sun, wind, and the current.
Yeah.
Current and stars.
So is it the sound, or say an example of the waves, is it the sound that's giving you the information, or the wave?
No,
the
not sound. And in nighttime we do that, but daytime we see that, because no more stars, huh?
Mm-hmm.
And we look the wave on the tower, computer can. In the ocean, is we use only 5 waves.
Oh.
Yeah. But we look on the tower, it look like 20 waves coming. But only 5 we look on the tower.
I mean, all the waves can add up to only 5 different kinds of waves.
Yeah, from the direction. You know, from where? One from northeast, one from east, southeast, south, north. See, 5. We make the trip to Micronesia, then Sori Perrin and I. We saw them about everything, the wave, stars, and the wind, because sometimes the wind changes. Everything, so repairmen saw them about that. Because when we make the trip to Micronesia, then I am on a canoe, but They feed in our kitchen. Sorry, Karen. You do that because I don't finish everything here.
How old are you?
Huh?
How old are you? No one knows it.
67.
Are you a grandfather?
Yeah.
You're a very humble man. Are you embarrassed by all this attention?
Yeah.
Was it overwhelming to go back to Santa Juan in this way?
Mm.
You probably get interviewed a lot, right? People always want to ask you about trips and everything.
Yeah.
Do you ever get tired of it?
Sometimes. Mm-hmm. Sometimes. Sometimes I get tired. Sometimes I'm okay.
I struggle with questions because I feel that it's such a big subject. So I really struggled with what to ask you. Yeah, and because I wanted to know what your feelings are too. You know, I mean, as far as the trip, it's sort of documented, right? And but I wanted to know what your feelings were. I saw some of the video where the send off. Can you put some of those feelings into it?
Well, my feeling is good, but I think better you want ask me something, question them. I think better than answer some because you know, yeah.
What did the Hawaiians give to your people as a gift?
What?
When you folks, did you have ho'okupu that you took to Santa Juan?
Yeah, in a sense.
Like the freeze and all of that, yeah. But it's more than that, though, anyway, so.
Well,
it's see, we view ourselves as separate people. You know, he's my father. He shot his father.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we're his sons. We live on different islands. So for us, it's like going home, right? As to what we gave to them, what you know, we brought to them, I think the contact and the assurance that we're there to support them in any way we can, is our family, because of what he's done in supporting us. Mau's family is not only in Hawaii, all over the South Pacific. Pacific Northwest, wherever he's landed, he's touched and he's talked. That's, you know, so, you know, if you ask a question about what gave, who gave what, or whatever, the physical, yeah, we took the freezer. And the freezer's for a reason, you know. And the reason behind why you wanted it, that's one side, but the connection, the bond, that's the.
Thank you.
See, with Mau told us now that he made the bridge, yeah, between Hawaii and Micronesia. And we're not Micronesian, Polynesian, Melanesian, whatever. Those lines are drawn by someone else. We're all islanders. We all think basically the same. We feel basically the same. We're spiritually, I think, intact as islanders. And in one sense, the waters separate us, yeah, but it also joins us because, so, you know, that feeling there is like when Mau comes to Hawaii, he comes home, yeah, yeah. When we go to Sarawa, we go home. That's why, if you remember, when you and I first talked about this, our master came to teach, and now his students taking him home. I mean, home. Make no difference what I live, but it's home.
Is it true?
Yeah, that's true.
good. Everybody's coming back. Did I not ask something you should have?
Are you saying that the new canoe will be building? The Micronesian maybe?
You're building a new one, bigger kind.
Well, that's
which one? Which one?
Your canoe. The canoe we built for you.
Oh yeah, yeah.
That's we know.
Better we ask.
We know. Process of building a canoe here in Hawaii.
For him. To take home to his island. So it's one from one fire into the next fire. Just.
Yeah, because I need the canoe like Makali, because my Korean canoe is single canoe, not too good for surfer. We use that only like from here to Honolulu.
Oh, the Micronesia?
Micronesia,
uh-huh,
too, but cannot from here to Micronesia. Or Micronesia to here. Too far, but the canoe is too small, so...
It's going to be used as a floating classroom. Because the places he's got to touch when he starts teaching is all to Micronesia. You know, not just like between islands. It's all to Micronesia, so one of the concepts behind this is to build something big enough where he can go and stay in peace. And from there move on to something a longer distance.
How big is it?
Yeah. We're not sure yet. Probably about 40 feet. Maybe, yeah, Papa?
Yeah.
Well, I see it's home, both places. I really see that. The Western perspective is always so oriented towards here and there. Yes, made it clear. This is home to you too.
You know, that's why generations have a hard time identifying the culture, because there's so much exposure nowadays. It's hard to live the culture. It's hard to be disciplined enough to, like with Papa, and the way he was taught, yeah, 5-4 years old. But now there's so much avenues that you gotta go to just to survive in this part of the world that. It's hard for students to do that, yeah? And to live the culture. Learning navigation is not going on every night and just watching stars and jumping on a canoe every couple of days and feeling the ocean. You live it every single day. And with that, along navigation comes everything else, because you're learning all the elements and how to utilize elements, plants and everything. So with Papa, he's a navigator, grandmaster navigator, but he's also very, very knowledgeable in Laula Pa'au. Very, very knowledgeable in planting, how he uses the moon and everything for planting, for fishing, for building things, survival. But because he lived the culture, he lived it every day. For example, we live it a little while, we jump in the car with KTA, buy something for drink, or go on 7-Eleven. These guys, you go to the island no more.
You make everything.
The 7-Eleven is a coconut tree. Boom.
You know. Did you make your own salad?
Mm-hmm. Salad is every day they make salad.
Here,
senate
is like gold in Hawaii, right?
Well, because plenty senate in Nassau. They grow back. By them is no more store, they make the senate every day because they use for the canoe, use for the house.
Do you see your island becoming more, with more conveniences?
More what?
More modern things.
more modern things? Are there more modern things coming to your island that make you
work? No.
So no electricity?
No. The light is, there is the lamp. Kerosene lamp. They used the coconut oil before, long time ago.
They burn the coconut oil in the lamp? Or the kerosene?
They boil the coconut milk. They come out and they use that for
and cooking is also all
cooking is a fire. They make fire. No stoves, no. But this time they used stove. Before, no more stove. They used the fire. This time they used the fire.
You must be the most well-traveled person on your island.
Huh? Yeah.
we can have bread with little whipsy.
Huh?
The World Indigenous People's Conference. Then, have a future World Indigenous People program. The World Indigenous People program on education and education, Mau comes in. So we get back Sunday from Hilo, and Monday we start the we're doing the Micronesian voyage canoe.
Fantastic.
So it's boom 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 boom, and in the process of doing that, we're talking about doing this canoe for.
Lots of good things to do. Thank you for all that you've done, even for people that you don't even know, like people like me. I'm not a canoe person or anything,
yeah,
but
yeah.
You've really enriched my life and everyone's life.
Not that you met him, but you know the reason why he did it.
Yes.
And yeah. I think people say, well, how come you, you know, especially with me, Charlie and something, you're so dedicated to men. You have to sit on the top there.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah. And so I ask him, why am I so adamant about the culture? But you know, when you go to an island like where he's from, and you go home to Sarawak, then no one, you know, still intact. Still just a very intact. Language is intact, the culture system, spiritual system is still intact. And you know the best thing about it? They can survive without anybody being there.
Wow. They don't need the rest of the world. You know, they're self-sufficient.
One of the most awesome feelings for us was us being able to sit in the canoe of the men's house in Sarawak. And after being told stories about home for so many years, and then to be able to sit there and to be able to sleep there and allow to dream and feel a presence, you know. That's awesome.
When you go back and you're teaching?
In my island.
On your island?
Yeah. Sorry. But I don't know, so somebody like put me in Panape. He teaches everybody in Panape. I don't know, when I go home, I don't see that what they do.
You must know everyone on the island,
oh,
huh?
Yeah. The time to go my business, yeah. Go to Bonaparte. First time the people in Bonaparte, they know that church. Because before nobody do that. That's what. See, they see the church. They think, oh, maybe we grab him, stay here. Never will go to him island. They want to meet. Hey, I go home first then. you guys thinking about me. Now I like home. Then I think that people in Chuuk, my family in Chuuk is they say, can you stay here? Oh, maybe I go home first. And like me, start teaching in Chuuk. When I come back from Saipan, the chief in my island said to me, you need to go somewhere, you stay there, start teaching the young men. But when I was there before the trip to my community, every Friday I teach the young men in my island.
So it's mostly men, the males, who live in that
community? No, the women too.
Women too. Fewer worries about your people keeping the traditions going?
Yeah.
Because more, there's more interest?
Yeah. Yeah, that's why I make the bridge between Magnus and Violation, because I like make big family around the world. Because I was thinking maybe I teach my people in my community and nobody knows me here. Too bad, because I know the state before is very like the people in my community. They say no, around the world, no compass, no everything before. No kind of. But now you see, some they use the compass or everything for the sailing in ocean. That's why they use that like 16 or what. That's why they lost the culture, because they throw away the Easter new things come from somewhere. Coming, eh? Nobody followed that custom before.
Your grandfather taught you, or?
Yeah, my grandfather. When I was young, maybe 4 years old, then I started learning from him.
How did he teach you? Did you go out on the canoe with him?
Yeah.
He taught you by being.
Yeah, when I was young and he goes somewhere, then he take me on a canoe, he's gonna swim me. There, at the stars, wait, the bird, the fish, staying down.
And it was all oral, nothing written down, huh?
With all our traditions.
So we have to remember.
Yeah. That's why I thought, sorry, when I give him everything, better he keep inside here than inside the book, inside the paper. Sometimes we lost them. You know, good when you do this, because maybe later on or sometime the young kids, they read anything you guys write down, and maybe they listen to the tape and they know about it. Or they think about the culture.
This will help.
Yes.
Why had a vessel that reflected the design of the ancients, they could not sail in the way of the ancients. There was no one who could teach them the art of traditional celestial navigation. The traditional navigators had a sophisticated system of sailing by the stars, using the heavens, the waves, winds, and other natural clues to fix positions and determine which way to sail.
We never had time to learn navigation. In fact, we didn't even quite know how to do it.
An exhaustive search through Polynesia was frustrating and turned up no viable candidates. Eventually, they learned about a navigator from the tiny atoll of Satawa in Micronesia, named Mau Piailug. He was considered an exceptional navigator who came from a culture of navigators dating back hundreds of years. In his tradition, he was recognized as a master, a Po navigator. In Satawa, navigators were chosen at birth. The young boys were tutored by their grandfathers according to oral traditions that came from generations before. Their maps to new lands were found in the skies, and they were guided by a compass of stars found only in the heavens. They learned the stars, the currents, the winds, developing an intuitive understanding of the cosmos and a deep trust, respect, and understanding of the sea.
I told him about the project. I could hardly finish talking, and he let go with a barrage of words. He said, you have to do this. Of course you have to do this. How can Polynesians live without sailing?
Mau Piailug agreed to navigate the Hawaiian canoe Hokulea on her maiden voyage to Tahiti. Mau would navigate in the traditional way, using only his knowledge of the heavens and the ocean. There would be no compass, no maps, no Western navigational instruments.
We're in Snug Harbor. It is a big circle of people sitting around, and Mau was in the circle, and I don't remember who it was, but I was in the circle, kind of just sitting there. Had never talked to him yet. And someone said, "Hey, Mau, where's the Southern Cross?" And Mau looks up and he goes, "Over there, behind his back." So I broke out of the circle. I ran all the way down the docks till I got past all the lights. And right there was a Southern Cross behind his back. And I said, "This is a man of magic."
I didn't even think that we were ever going to meet this guy. But I came onto the canoe, and from far away, I recognized that he was a special spirit, a special person. I know he can speak English, and I couldn't speak his language. So we just started, communication was actually no problem at all. Everything just started flowing as if we knew each other already.
He started teaching us how to lash the canoe. To start to learn the stars from him, and it was real different. So he would do this thing where we'd be sitting down, you know, on the pier. Put you over there, he'd put me over there, he'd put another person there, and he'd situate you, and he'd teach us a dance, and he'd sing. And we start the dance, and he'd tell us how to move. Well, what he was teaching us was how stars move relative to each other, and things as they rise and set, you know, and things. And your motion, you are a star, and your motions depict the movement of the star.
Mau was that one that was able to come back to our culture and help us to remember that these things that were magic to watch him do all these things, and they're still magical to us. To be at the level that he's at, he's helped us to reconnect again.
If I wanted to know anything, about the stars, the ocean, about weight, and he would just like, he just like give me the answer right there. It was just like, and it went right through him to me, and then it represented who he was and everybody he learned from, you know, the past and everything. So it's like a living ancestor that you could find it to talk to.
It took an extraordinary effort to prepare Kule'an and the crew for the voyage to Tahiti. The canoe would have to withstand for 40 days on the open ocean, had to be provisioned with food and water, and whatever might be needed in the event of any emergency. The crew of novices needed to train for this long journey so that they could handle the physical rigor of a 2,500-mile voyage.
A great deal was being said among the paddling clubs that those guys aren't going to get that canoe built. We got it built. And they said, those guys aren't going to sail. That canoe won't sail. Well, we sailed it. And then they said, well, it won't go to Tahiti.
Raindrops, they hamper my vision. On May 1st, 1976, Hokulea began her epic voyage, a 2,500-mile journey from Hawaii to Tahiti.
Tribulation carry us down to our destination. Oh, wiki wiki.
I want to sail to Tahiti. I don't want to fly to Tahiti. I want to see it come out of the ocean. I want to fish the shit out of the sea. So I knew I wanted to sail there. I never knew it would be on Hokulea.
Looking up, they all make us hikers. Hokulea, Hokulea, star of gladness. Oh, Hokulea, star of gladness. Stand beside me and be my friend.
Be my friend.
Make me smile and laugh again, yes. Hokulea,
Hokulea,
you're the star of gladness.
You're the happy star.
Mau had that certainty about it. Just so above petty. Mau was everything. He wasn't just a navigator. I mean, in our canoe family, Hokulea is the mother, and Mau's the father. He was our doctor, taught us 101 ways of using a coconut. It wasn't until I got on a canoe that I really understood what a coconut was for, and how important it was to our people.
He stayed awake for days and days and days, and he never even like dozed. I made sure that I was there all the time just to do whatever I could. On that voyage, we got to experience what it was like in the old days. The plants had to stay alive. The pig had to make it and be healthy enough to make the voyage.
There were Hawaiians on board who sailed for cultural reasons, and there were scientists who sailed as part of an experiment in cultural anthropology. As the voyage wore on and fatigue set in, tension grew between the crew members.
I was doing something very Hawaiian, very ancient, and I didn't want anything to interrupt that. And at times, that's what it became, an interruption, these things. They were, to me, unnecessary.
It was my shirt. It was 1976. We were rock up somewhere in the Kwana, Hokulea. Somewhere where we were now. Somewhere where we were in the Mabakan. We ran up soon, take you one other. Sorry, me take. Miss Agaria, Miss Alga. Now, among a saddle fairy, we don't put a saddle curricula.
The differences between the scientific and cultural aspects of the voyage intensified until it culminated in physical conflict near the end of the journey.
They just weren't well enough used to each other, motivated in the same ways, didn't have the objectives of the voyage that clearly fixed in their minds.
After 31 days at sea, Hokulea made landfall in a glorious arrival witnessed by more than 17,000 Tahitians. It was as if Hokulea had breathed life into all of the Polynesian myths and legends about ancient seafaring. The pathway to Tahiti had been reopened, and something long dormant began to stir in the hearts and minds of all Polynesians.
Couldn't keep people off. And you know, the people on board were like the mayor, the governor, and his wife, and all their family come first. You know, it's like all the kids. We couldn't keep the kids off. And everybody's dancing, and you know, it's just, you couldn't stop it.
While all of Tahiti feted Hokulea and her crew, Mau, disheartened by his crew's undisciplined behavior during the voyage, slipped out of Tahiti, leaving his students tape-recorded instructions on how to return to Hawaii. His disappointment was so bitter, he vowed never to sail with the Hawaiians again, and the crew was forced to rely on Western navigational instruments to make its way back to Hawaii.
The navigators were losing prominence within the Micronesian culture, and he saw very clearly that his own stature as a navigator would increase as a result of his association with Hokulea. But Mau did not see this for a reason of personal self-aggrandizement, but for the reason that he wanted to see the art of navigation as it was practiced in Satawal to continue.
Tiba-tiba kapung ini, bukan air lagi show, main ferry kan, orang kena air kita.
Literally and figuratively, the art of traditional navigation is helping native peoples throughout Polynesia find their way in a modern world that does not always value traditional practices.
Happy because now is I know the people here is they learn a little bit from me. That's why they start try again. But me, I never go with them, but my body feel good because I know they get a little bit navigator. But maybe they can do sometime, but better.
The cultural rejuvenation failed to reach the distant shores of Micronesia. There, Western cultural attitudes continued to threaten traditional lifestyles and values.
Kira wajib bersih dari rock kira de. Arman lagi rockor, lagi dengan rockor. Ia kira asal. Kira wajib pernah dari rockor ngah perlu ti rerai. Ia rapi ngau sefei, ngau kiri rungkan. So pilih dua ini dikapi di paling sebuah terara pun ngau isuri mita pun ngau isu pasir mita pun kira apa yang kita jadi mulai mita pun dengan dipuji pula upor itu ramai nang ya fikir dengan itu meskipun ngau orang mereka. Semua sembelih rumah dekat saya juga. Itu pun mereka juga setiap merawat kau. Mungkin kita tahu tu kita merawat tarik tarik water.
The thing about culture is that people who have lost their past become a lost people. In complete acceptance of the modern culture, they should not lose the cultural past that has given them the guidance that has made them successful. And without that past, we are simply rudderless.
Clay Bertelmann had started this movement to build a canoe for Mau.
My brother Clay, he really wanted it for Mau, really badly. It was like a small thing that we could muster up for the greatness that he shared. It was something.
Clay committing to it, and all of us understanding that with Clay, that no matter what, he was going to do it, whether the materials were there or not, or whether the money was there or not, but that somehow he'd find a way to do it.
It took us over 5 years of working. It was hard just because, for one thing, it came at a time when we lost Clay.
When he passed, I think for a lot of us, we understood that with his passing, his commitment was still for us to carry it through. It's a tremendous gift to a man that's worthy of the kind of gift, because that canoe is gonna go beyond Mau's life. It'll teach a whole new generation of Micronesian seafarers. And we expect nothing back because we've been given so much already.
I don't know what else we could have done, things that would demonstrate the appreciation we have for what he's given us.
With Clay's passing, Mau assumed responsibility of overseeing the construction of his canoe, the Alangano Maisu. But there was another reason for Mau to stay in Hawaii. He had been stricken with diabetes, and his failing health required a level of medical attention not available to him in Micronesia. If Mau remained in Hawaii, dialysis would enable him to prolong his life, but he would never be able to return Satawal or witness the arrival of Maisu on the sands of his birth. For every navigator, no landfall is more precious than arriving safely home. And so it is for Mau. He returned to Satawal to receive the Maisu, leaving his son Cesario to sail in his place. Alangano Maisu, accompanied by Hokulea and the escort boat Kamahele, left Hawaii to travel west for 45 days to her new home, Satawal. It was the first voyage into the northwestern Pacific for all vessels. It was also the highest honor Mau's students could pay him.
Raindrops hamper my vision.
Good luck.
Falling down in the teeming season. In my mind, while we sail away our time.
To see her on the water was really, really special for me. More than the fact that she's fast, she's strong. And she's got all these different personalities. She's got this deep sense of strength. I think that kind of surprised everybody. She's got this drive to always want to move, and that's my dad.
It's the first voyage we sailed with multiple canoes where the canoes had to stay together. Beyond the physical requirements of staying together, the symbolism behind that, what I think is so key, that the voyage transcends the organizations, it transcends separate communities, it transcends nations. Because now you're talking Micronesian, Hawaii, coming together.
Mau told us in the beginning to stay together. Yeah. That for us as people, we need to stay together. For the success of what we need to do, stay together.
He consistently said that throughout the whole process of the building of Maisu, no matter what, you folks stick together. And so for me, I hope that we're all listening to that.
In this we pray, Lord, please show us the way.
Sailing together in the largest ocean on the planet was no simple task, And challenges would be part of the long voyage until the very end. Approaching Sotomayor, the crews encountered a fierce storm. Yet another test of the knowledge passed on to them from Mau.
Maybe we should protect this guy by tying it down as much as we can to protect this, because it could be raining for a while. No, we're just going to keep going. We're about 200 miles to go.
Then we hold to and get centered for the island in the morning. Everybody can talk to each other, communicate, do whatever logistical planning, and I think everybody just really start to get spiritually ready for tomorrow.
That day we saw Sotomayor coming out of the ocean, and it wasn't a vociferous moment, it was a quiet moment. It's like, there's your heaven, you know, you come home.
Us going to Sotomayor was, it was an awesome thing. It was awesome to go there and see the island, meet the people, see old friends, and it really took you back in time. It made us appreciate even more, you know, what we're trying to recover.
Hokulea finally embraced the sands of Sotomayor, the source of the navigational knowledge that guided her more than 100,000 miles throughout the Pacific.
The day that we arrived there, in my mind, that might have been the most significant island on the planet.
The canoe was just the vessel to be able to get us there, so that we could all experience for a short amount of time what it was like to go back again.
As the Hawaiians arrive with their gift, Sotomayor is bustling in preparation for the anticipated visitors.
They harvest from the sea and they harvest from the land. They're not surviving, they're thriving.
We come here today to present your gift, Alingana Maisu. Behind this gift, thousands of people, people from islands of the ocean. The people you see here represent the people and blessings and welcome. Aloha. Ha, kiyo,
Satwan. Our chiefs on Satwan. And people of Sotomayor, all that we are thankful for this gift. The property now that is for all of us, people of Sotomayor, we cannot return like gift. But I'd like to request that the least we can do is give the poor to those that are recognized among our friends from Hawaii.
The highest honor given to a navigator in Setawal is to become Pwo, Master Navigator. The ritual was implemented for the first time in over 50 years as part of the exchange. Mau decided to honor 16 navigators with Pwo. Included were five Hawaiians, Nainoa Thompson, Shorty Bertelman, Bruce Blankenfeld, Chad Baibayan, and Chad Paishon. Mau's son Cesario was also recognized as a master navigator. Now in the twilight of his life, Mau presided over the ceremony that would formally confer his knowledge to a younger generation and invigorate the ancient tradition.
I would like to offer on behalf of all that are here today that with the deepest humility and with the deepest appreciation, we are very, very honored to be here today with all of you within this ceremony of Pwo.
What the Pwo is about is the navigators accepting the kuleana of being the steward of that art. That you're a teacher, you're a caretaker, you have to recruit new people in so the art can keep on living. So we're faced with the same challenges that Mau is faced with here on the island.
You know, you could just feel the, you know, the energy and the importance and, you know, the real seriousness of what, you know, he was trying to pass on.
For Mau, it's like he's passing the torch on, which is like he's always holding the torch for us, yeah. But now he's giving it away. So that was big for me.
It wasn't us giving something to him. Basically, he was doing it again. He was giving us something again. So it was. It was just, you know, he's still the teacher. He's still, you know, being the master.
These two canoes are connected by shared genealogies, but will now seek out their own destinies. Maisu, under the leadership of Cesario, will sail between the atolls of Micronesia as a floating classroom to engage future generations in the teachings of the past.
Stars, but your culture also. You become a very important man in carrying along the navigation God-given instrument, you might say. I mean, God's stars up there, they don't fail you like modern-day technology.
That's all because my grandfather. I remember when I died, nobody gave you anything. That's why I stay with you one at a time.
You've just come in from Coast Ryan. How long since you've had any sleep? How long since you've had any sleep?
Sleep is I'm a little bit sleeping, but my eyes are sleeping, but inside it's open.
So you always know what those stars are telling you, which direction you should go, but you haven't had any sleep now since you left Coast Ryan on Saturday, so this is Tuesday, so
yeah, but this trip is not too bad, not like going to the hills. Going to the hills is more hard. 31 days, I never sleep.
31 days you were up and doing all the navigation.
From Hawaii to Hawaii.
How old are you now?
67.
67, so for a man your age, that's quite a feat to go 31 days, knowing that the whole crew is depending upon your skills.
Yeah, that was. I remember before when I growing up, then my grandfather said, come, I show you something, one thing, tell you something, because my grandfather is not old, not great.
So when they teach you about how to navigate the stars, do they teach you how to anything about body duration, so that you know how to last on those days?
Navigation and build a canoe, build a house, anything. Medicine.
You've been to Tahiti on the canoe. You've been out here to Micronesia now. What other long ocean-going vessels or trips have you made?
Away to Tahiti.
So that was the longest one, 31 days in one direction. And that was really the test of endurance.
Yeah. This trip is away to Khartoum, Pune.
20 days to come from the Big Island Hawaii to Madeira. What do you have planned after this trip?
From Big Island to Machu, then Machu to Busai. Busai to here, here to Chu. All the way down to Saigon.
All the way to Saigon. Okay, it's starting to rain out here, so maybe we better.
Reguling, I'm with Tommy Lemita. You're pushing him, Sam. I'm with the one to pay with the rook, mati polna. Kulingan refangi pukuling po fatto pukuling. Kesa pukuling pari minna. Na edirti remisan remisan masan de. Kanu herti. Iti ruk. Ya mati meruk. Mati ngadi polna. Ina minne fari mu itar polna. Ina fari mu pute pari mu. Po etero putunan etero putur polna. Nain era samori polna. Kepisar samona ne kure kepisar kuring na. Ina sefata rimine fangi to kuring na nar. Ina to kuring wa to bitual bol. Eu pier polna berura ilipi. Ya lo. Ale to tolebo. No lo rera. Ano, itu terlalu betul betul itu tiada se, nggak fine. Hei mutu, ya tu aja buruk ter. Evan langi sorang masuk pura kuding mana, hei, yang ngangi, ya mutu ngadi, ya meta, meta, ipangan ngani kubar de, upang mau ngai mat, bisa pura kami warfari, meris mat ipa pura kami warfari, asfer ter itu itar ulos mat. Rama ni rumah mahu repair ngar, harus buat mahu ngemat, ya, support lagi luar fadi, harus ngemat, support lagi luar fadi harus ada, ya, semua orang, kalau pukit terfrotna, menerima rafsi ramota, otoran menerima pukit apa, right to point orang dia sak, itu ka. Walau pun itu dalam sesak, yang dipot free itu dikeparu ramai. Orang itu kote no, dia tu apa? Kita rujuk kedua, yang orang apa itu foto terutama dalam sesak, ofisnya minta pilih apa? Yang orang anda baru kuningu, kuningu eluling eluling, dah faham apa dah sesak? Kalau moga moga kuningu, harap apa? Ngesor soto kau dah lindo, kau muri larap, amak, yang anda itu, dia mana pun ada apa, dah ini, polau polau kuning apa mati seperti itu, aw, ya matang beri terle, manusia semua yang ini beti, firda ini ya ini marpi pura ini mau, ini pura repio, ya tu ya, kalau ngan fef, rel di tu amatang ini kuning. Kuning apa le? Aku deh pun, itu apa le? Arabi pun dia. Sama orang semalam tu, di fasa ni kuli aku seru kuning na. Aku deh metal for ngan ibu pun. Angan itu nara, pun angan ibu super, pakai tu itu sebut. Sebut ngan deh metas, ngan deh pa. Sama orang angan ibu rawat tu, awi water pun. Wui utara pon apa, rukiri, menaikukun. Arre, dimaikuru kare, jepuru kina. Ayam rawasuk.
The Waka Te Aurere will be named after this place, Te Aurere Beach. Here at Heck's home, work will begin on the Waka using expertise from around the Pacific. Mau Piailug from Sotawal in the Carolines is one of the few surviving star navigators. He brings with him the knowledge of our voyaging ancestors, knowledge lost in Aotearoa. Nainoa Thompson from Hawaii has been Mau's student for over 10 years and 30,000 miles of ocean voyaging on the Hukulea.
Where did you learn all of this?
Oh, me?
Yeah.
Oh, from my grandfather.
From your grandfather?
Yeah.
How old were you when you learned it?
Oh, maybe I could 5 years old.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Have you used this on many other waka?
Mm-hmm.
As a boy, Mau listened to the stories of the old navigators. When it was time to sleep, he would lie down beside his grandfather who told him, if he learned navigation, he would have a name, he would be respected, he would eat navigators' food, and when he voyaged, he would be higher than a chief. Mau brings with him lashing methods different from ours.
You make like this one. Leave it this way.
two times like the same.
As each knot is tightened, it tightens the three before it. And when wet, the lashing tightens even more. The Akun place this
way.
On Satawal, the navigator's knowledge is passed on only to a chosen few.
Or this way.
Mau has decided to break with tradition and teach everyone who wants to learn.
If you own it, then do it here at the Mirapurka. It's a Mirapurka, see, I put you here, put you here.
Monday afternoon, having lunch.
What are we having today?
We are having turkey ala king on crackers, lemon sweet cocktail. We have bossing food, fresh apple we got about 2 hours ago. Water.
Man's greatest need, fresh,
pure water. What is it? Just gave you some love. Is that? All right, sir.
Is it one?